Hi guys, this is Michael Vincent. Welcome to another session in the Mastering Magic series. Today, I'd like to talk about books and DVDs and generally how magic is being learnt today in 2017. I'd like to take you back in time, 1974. That's when I became interested in magic. I saw magicians on television, Doug Henning, Fred Capps, Ricky Jay, and I was so enchanted with the subject, I went to my local library and I asked the librarian if they had any books on magic. And to my surprise, they had a whole collection of magic books. The Royal Road to Card Magic by Gene Hugard, Modern Magic, Magic of the Masters, The Magic Book by Harry Lorraine. These were books I got from my library. I learned all of my magic through reading books. This is a very important thing to consider compared with how magic is being taught today. From 1974 to 1980, everything I knew about sleight of hand with cards, close-up magic, I learned from classic books. One Christmas, my mother purchased for me Stars of Magic and the Seinfeld book, Seinfeld's Entertaining Card Magic. I was in heaven. These are the books that became my Bible. 1980 was a landmark event for me and my friends in magic. It was the first time we saw the great Ed Marlowe on videotape. £50 for a videotape, that's what it cost. We put our money together and we purchased this video and we saw the great Marlowe shuffling cards. We were blown away by his magic. That video was the birth of a whole new generation of how magic information would be shared. For the next decade or so, a huge boom in magical education through videos. The DVD generation came a little bit later. When you compare reading a book with watching a video or DVD, something gets lost in translation. When you read a book, you have to interact with the written word. You've got to bring the written word to life. You've got to make sense of it, interpret it. Sometimes you might make a mistake, and your mistake may be creative, and you come up with something different. When you watch a video, you get everything. The mannerisms, the gestures, the words, the patter, the performance. The human brain is like a video recorder. As you're watching, you see everything. You're recording everything. And you will not be able to help yourself. This has happened to me. You adopt the mannerisms of the person you're watching. Even the language pattern, the phrasing, the styling. Not a good thing. I had to force myself to stop watching videos and go back to the one thing I was good at, reading. I love reading magical literature. It's a trip into another world. I remember the great Larry Jennings once saying in a book, I think it was Di Vernon's Ultimate Card Secret. Jennings was talking about Vernon when he was a young man reading Vernon's tricks. He said it was like taking a walk inside the mind of Vernon and experiencing the craft of magic through his eyes to see how they think, what they thought about certain things, how they felt. I thought this was a beautiful thing. When I read a magic book, I am studying the craft of magic through someone else's eyes in the hope I may see something that may be of value to me that I can use and develop into something beautiful. So, my friends, this is a very important video because I would like you to readdress your balance between how much videos are you watching compared to the quality of reading that you are engaged in. Let me share something with you. Last year, I read a wonderful book by Ascanio, the structural conception of magic. Oh my God, it is the most beautiful book. It's pure theory and philosophy. I loved every single word of this book. I had to stop myself at times to applaud and to celebrate what I just read. The magical atmosphere, the hierarchy of learning magic, the stages of development. Ascanio was a genius. He really understood magic as a craft and what needed to happen to elevate it to the plateau of artistic expression. I'd like all of you to get this book and read it and experience the beauty of this book for yourself. And share your comments down below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I have a lot more to share, but I'll save that for another video. For now, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.